What it do, what it is, I'm Jakon Milan, and today we're going to get into some hot topics today. And we're going to talk about Romante versus Cardi B. And is it more profitable to be ghetto when you're not black? And also, we're going to get into JT versus G to the L to the O, Glorilla's epic read-off they had against each other, and who read who, and who was just talking. Now, of course, this is my opinion, and everybody has their opinion, but this is mine.
You ain't gonna understand everything. And everything ain't meant for you to understand.
How do you know what's good for me?
That's my opinion! Don't you get it? Why can't anybody have an opinion but you?
What's up, y'all? It's your boy Jakon Milan back with another YouTube video, my third YouTube video. Yes, and if you haven't already, please go watch my first YouTube video and my first ever vlog. Make sure you like, comment, and share on those. And also, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can get into some things with me at all times and have your notifications on. Now, as you can see from the intro, this is going to be called That's My Opinion. Because at the end of the day, this will be my unfiltered opinion about trending topics and events that's going on in the world or the internet that I feel like I want to talk about or I have something to bring to the conversation. And also, I would always like to hear your guys' opinion. So make sure you comment and just like and subscribe to the channel, please, to keep it going. Okay, so like I said, we're getting into some things and we're diving deep. And this is all my opinion. So first on the docket, we have Romante versus Cardi B. And this conversation opens up a lot of conversations if you really think about it. Because first of all, Cardi B got hit with a stray. And Cardi B got hit with a stray. And I understand her frustration. She's a Libra, so I definitely get why it's like, why you put me in it? What this got to do with me?
Now, why am I in it?
And you could have did it. See, how I get it wrong? Because you never apologized.
So like I said, I can definitely see how Cardi B could have got on her knee, how I get in it type of ish, because it was just like, this had nothing to do with me. But also, sometimes I wish people wouldn't get so offended all the time and more so uplift the people that is on a come up, you know what I mean? But anywho, that's a video for a whole different day. But anywho, at any rate, he was really upset with Essence Magazine, and him and Essence Magazine had words. I will have the tweet exchange on the side of me. You can pause and read. But him and Essence Magazine had words, and Essence Magazine basically covered his birthday trip and basically said that, you know, black creators don't get paid as well as other creators, which is true. But I also get where Romante was coming from. You know, he's an Aries and he's always going to speak up. You know, Aries going to say what they say, and they said what they said at the end of the day. And you just got to live with it. But I just feel like he just didn't want to seem like the ghetto, I don't get it, you know, I'm the poor influencer type, don't use me as a bad example, was what he was basically giving. Don't try to use me as a bad example because I'm okay. And I get what he was saying. But, you know, Aries are so aggressive that they come off very aggressive and very rude-like. But that's not their intentions. They're just very intent. And they just say what they got to say and put it on the table. And it is what it is. So, anyway, after that, he said about Essence, people came in to question if Romante was even considered an influencer, which I found profound, and it kind of made me question, what do we consider an influencer today? What is an influencer? If you don't mind, comment what you feel like an influencer is in the comments to try to make me understand better, because I'm a content creator, but I also feel like I'm an influencer as well, but I don't know. I don't know the definition. It changes every 6 months. But I feel like what people think influencing is, is when you can sell a product. You know, like if I am using a new makeup brush, I should be able to sell that product out because I am an influencer. If I start a new t-shirt business, I should be able to sell that out because I am an influencer. People want to wear or eat or be where I am. Or do you think an influencer is somebody who is able to influence you into coming back to watching their videos, into having a good day, into thinking about things positively? Or is it the latter of? I don't know which one people feel is an influencer, and it kind of gets morphed. But I'm going to read a tweet that somebody tweeted to Ramonte, and this is what made me even start this. What is an influencer? Okay, and first I want to say that Essence tried to gaslight Ramonte so hard with that "I'm disappointed in your response." I hate it when my parents used to say that, or any adult used to say that to me growing up, like, "I'm disappointed in your behavior that caused me to respond that way. Let's really wake it up and let's really talk about it." Because at the end of the day, y'all don't reach out to him for his opinion or him a quote for y'all magazine. Y'all just make a quote for him. So I would feel some type of way too, because at the end of the day, content creators need the exposure. Okay, we need the exposure, and heck yeah, we need the money, but we also need the exposure too. So that would have been a good look for him to be in Essence, you know what I mean? And really give his opinion on this whole black content creator versus white content creator, who gets paid this and that, because he does have millions of followers and he really is an influencer. I always see Ramonte going viral. But that was just something that I just wanted to get out there too. Essence really tried to gaslight. They was like the older parent trying to gaslight you, like, "Don't disrespect your parents or your days will be short." You know what I mean? When you know you right, they kind of try to make you feel like you wrong. But this is the tweet that I was talking about. Okay, so here's the tweet. They said, "I love Ramonte, but I think people get confused with someone who has a large following versus someone who is actually an influencer. I don't think Ramonte would be qualified as an influencer because he doesn't influence his followers to buy, purchase things. That's not how he became known." And then somebody said, "When brands look for ambassadors, they like niche influencers with niche audience. Example equals Keith Lee audience who loves food, brand deals with food brands. E. Kane audience loves wigs, brand deals with wig companies." And while I think this is true, and I do agree, two things can be true, but I think it's also perception, because I feel like me, I am an astrology, you would say, niche content, but I feel like if I wanted to sell a wig to my followers, they will buy it. I feel like if I wanted to sell a jacket, if I wanted to sell a water bottle, if I wanted to sell something to my followers and it really, I feel like it can help them, and I feel like it's a great product, I feel like I can sell it to my product. And I get what people are saying with the big audience versus really influencer, because there is a lot of people out here with a big audience and no influence. Heck, sometimes I feel like I'm one of those people that have a big audience and no influence. But then I go on my DMs and then I read my comments and I just get on live with my people and I see that I influence people every day in small ways, maybe not on a Keith Lee level, but I do have some influence, and we all as influencers have power. And I don't like how people try to take the power away from people by saying things like, "Is he an influencer or does he just have a large following?" What's really the difference? Because at the end of the day, I get it. You can have a large following and not know how to monetize it and not know how to use it. I never wanted to be one of those people who didn't know how to make money off social media. And that's why I said I'm going to bring that to y'all, because I feel like people leave out secrets to help people become content creators and help them make money. That's coming soon. But right now, this is about, that's my opinion. And my opinion is, if you have a big following and you're steadily going viral and you're always in the blogs and you're always interacting with celebrities, and celebrities want to take pictures with you, want you to be with them. He was just walking with JT. He was just in another female rapper's video. He was in another female rapper video before that. I mean, at the end of the day, he has influence. Ramonte has influence, and he deserves the things of the things of the things that he deserves. Look at the material. I mean, at the end of the day, look at the material. He is a fun influencer. Just like there's these rich, luxurious influencers that just go out and shop at Target and shop at Gucci and Prada and Louis Vuitton all day, and y'all eat it up. is the same thing as Ramonte. He's just that every day, this is my life. I'm not just the richest person in the world, but this is my life. I still enjoy my life, and I still have fun. Child, I done got off topic talking about influencing because it's a lot. But that brings us right back to our topic. Cardi B versus Ramonte. And like I said all that to say, Cardi B got hit with a stray, okay? So Ramonte basically was saying that it's because people perceive him as ghetto. That's why he feel like he doesn't get the brand deals that he deserve. And he said, what's the difference in me and Cardi B? You know, she was ghetto when she first came out. She was a gangbanger. Blase, blase. So he was basically just saying, like, what's the difference between her ghetto and my ghetto? And that's where I bring the question is. That's where I bring the question in. I mean, I'm sorry. I'm going to make mistakes, y'all. That's where I bring the question in. Is it more profitable to be ghetto when you're not black? Because these tweet exchanges, Cardi B missed the mark. And it's okay sometimes when you miss the mark, or, you know, sometimes when you're arguing so fast that you're just not getting what the person is saying, and you automatically want to think they're attacking you, and you're responding without listening, and you're responding not to understand, but to just respond. It sounds cute and it's put together real well, but does it even make sense? And here are the tweets. Okay, so I cannot find the tweet that Ramonte first said about, you know, him comparing himself to Cardi B, which I always think that's a bad thing to do for a gay man to do. Never. I'm not trying to give no advice or tell people how to live their life, but never compare yourself to a woman, even if it does align with what you're saying, which I do think it aligned with what Ramonte was saying. But just don't do it. It'll just save yourself the heartache and the hardship. Because at the end of the day, you know, there is no comparison sometimes. You know what I mean? Sometimes you just have to push through and wait for your turn and your time. And that just goes to show you perception. Because I feel like Ramonte Nim is one of the creators that I feel like is doing good. You know what I mean? He's living that life with the celebrities. He's living. You know what I mean? From what you see. But it's always something that you want more out there. And sometimes I feel like that with my content, with doing astrology. I want to do so much more. I want to break down barriers, break down walls, bust through windows. And sometimes you feel like you get stuck in this ghetto or astrology or lifestyle content, and you feel like it's hindering you. But sometimes you just have to keep the path until you get to where you're going. And I'm sorry, y'all. I keep on going off topic. Let me get into it. And I'm also going to have the tweets up here so that you guys can pause and read if you need to. But I'm going to read them too. Okay, so this was Cardi B's response back to him because I can't find the first tweet. She said, it's crazy because when I became famous, people said I'm ghetto. Talk ish about my accent. Call me dumb because the way I speak. Say I got no couth. Talk about my teeth, my braids, my two buns. And to this day, no matter what I accomplish, they still call me a stripper. All because I'm from the ghetto. People misinterpret me because apparently I'm loud and ghetto till this day. Call me a hood rat in awe. When I sat down with Bernie Sanders and Joe Biden, they called me a ghetto stripper. Why is that? Y'all got to use me to make y'all comparisons. Because y'all only see the glory, but not when I get dragged 24/7. Leave me alone. And out of the BS, which, like I said, I get it because she did get hit with a stray and it really had nothing to do with her. So I get where Cardi B was coming from. But I mean, girl, you were ghetto, child. You were ghetto. You were ghetto. That was one of the things that people liked about you. You were hood. You were raunchy. You were ghetto. You know what I mean? But you were able to benefit off of it and receive massive success, mainstream success. And that's basically what Ramonte was saying. Why don't people like Sexy Red get that same success? Why don't real gutta ghetto people really get the success that people who cosplay? And I'm not even saying Cardi B cosplay because she is really from the hood, I'm guessing. I'm really guessing she's from the hood. But she's not, you know, what are you mixed with?
Are you Italian? What color are you anyway? Are you some type of black or Spanish?
What color do you think I am? No, I'd like to know, what color do you think I am?
It's really hot in here.
It is kind of hot in here.
And that's no shade, but I just want to know. I'm pretty sure she already said it probably, but you know, I just want to know. So Ramonte responded back and he said, girl, why are you getting so mad at the comparison? I'm saying you are successful and reach heights that visibly black people, ghetto people have harder time reaching. Clock that T. They act like just like you. I'm not saying you don't deserve success or how you act is bad. I'm saying that if someone that was my color or darker acts the same way, we will never receive the same awards or love. You're being very dense. Sookie, Sexy Red, and the City Girls, list goes on. You've had major campaigns that ghetto black women and men like me will never get. It's a deeper conversation. I'm not trying to offend you at all. I'm not trying to offend you at all. To not think you have it easier to be seen as marketable because you're lighter is crazy. And that's where it comes in, colorism. Because colorism is real. And if you don't think colorism is real, maybe you're a colorist. Or maybe you're just an airhead. I don't know. Colorism is real. When they see something that is not black but acts black, it's more marketable to the mainstream audience. And they love it. They live for it. They live up for it. Okay. And period is the same thing. You know what I mean? It comes from the same roots. But okay is more marketable. It was on a Pepsi commercial. Let's wake it up and clock that T. Okay, let's keep it going. Okay, then Cardi B responded. She said, that's not what you said. You said nobody called me ghetto and now you're moving the goalposts. You know why I'm where I am right now? Because I took all those no's and recognized that I had to change. Now, when she said that, I don't think she's really changed a lot. You know, Cardi B still addresses whatever she want to address. She threw shoes at Nicki Minaj at something, and she's always remained, you know, herself, authentic. And that's one thing why her fans love her so much and go up for her, because she is authentic and she's never changed really, but she just got better with fashions, of course, but she's still her authentic self, and that's why the people love her. Okay, where was I at? I had to change the way I talk, the way I act, and the way I respond. You ignoring all of that and playing the color card because you don't like me. And it's effed up. You using all those other women. Sexy Red is making bangers and on tour with Drake. And I bet money she's going to win Female Rapper of the Year because she's grinding and working hard and not letting people call her ghetto distract her from the top. So miss me with that. At the end of the day, you said a whole bunch of nothing, Miss Cardi B, because you missed the whole point. You missed the goal. You're pushing the goal point. At the end of the day, you're a spicy Latina. And that's no shade to my Latino women. I love y'all down. But at the end of the day, you're more marketable to do all the ghetto stuff and be ghetto in a gangbanger, all that stuff. And you're still going to get a $5 million campaign because you're not black. Where is Sexy Red's campaign? Where is JT's campaign? Where is Carisha's campaign? Wait a minute. Child, that's a topic for a whole nother video. Anyway, but where is all the people who is authentically from the hood, ghetto black? Why can't we profit off ever being ourselves, but people can profit off being us? And I think that's the bigger conversation that Cardi B missed. So to basically wrap it all up, basically Cardi B said that you just saying all this because you don't like me. That's basically what she chalked it up to, because he is a barb. I don't know if he's an official barb, but he do like Nicki Minaj and he does love JT. So maybe she just chalked it up to that. But he ended up coming back and letting her know, like, girl, this don't have nothing to do with me not liking you. Like, this is real tea. I just used you as an example. Maybe I shouldn't have used you, but I used you as an example because it was more, he felt like people can get the message clear because it is like she really was ghetto gutter. You know what I mean? Teeth messed up, hair messed up. Everything was from the bottom, you know what I mean? And she got to build herself up. So, like I said, it was a good comparison. You just shouldn't have done it, though. But this is what he said to end it all out. What I'm trying to say is that her being ghetto or being called ghetto doesn't hinder her career. Essence wrote an article and asked, why was my viral birthday trip not sponsored by any brands? And y'all said, It's because I'm ghetto and not marketable. So I'm giving an example of another person who is ghetto and has reached a high level of success. It didn't hinder her. So why should it hinder me? That's all. I didn't mean to offend her or get her dragged. I use her as example because her ghetto ratchetness is what helped propel her career. It was called being relatable. This is not no Stan Twitter S. This is real life politics. Within the black community and entertainment industry, I'm confused on why I'm getting so much hate. Now, he ate him up with that. I'm not going to lie. And people want to hear what they want to hear and they want to read what they want to read. But he ate them up with that. He ate them up. Because at the end of the day, she was a good example. I said that, but you just shouldn't have did it. I don't know. You just shouldn't have did it because that was going to, that's what they can use against you and turn it around. And at the end of the day, the problem is that colorism is still a big deal. And, you know, classism is still a big deal. And racism is still a big deal. And until we really get to the heart of the situations, of course, people are going to be offended when they benefit off colorism and you're calling them out about colorism. When they don't either know that they're a colorist or don't care that they're a colorist. You know what I mean? And I'm not saying anyone's a colorist here. Hey, don't shoot me. I'm just saying. Something ain't clean in the water and he's trying to clean it up. And that was a good example. And instead of her getting angry, she could have uplifted him even more and said the nice thing that she said to him, you know, when they ended up, you know, getting it all mixed up. Like he said, I wish you would have said this to me the first time. And I might put that tweet up. I don't know. I might put that tweet up so y'all can see what she ended up did saying to him. That was positive. And they had a nice little end exchange. Do I think they will be friends after this? No, I do not. But what I feel like is influence is whatever you want it to be. If this person just influenced you to want to come see their videos every day and you don't want to buy their makeup, that's an influencer. If you want to buy their makeup and watch their videos every day, that is an influencer as well. Stop trying to define people and categorize people for what they do. You know what I mean? Every celebrity can't sell. You know what I mean? Every celebrity can't sell products, but you always want to watch what they're doing. So what is an influencer to you? We gotta find the definition and we gotta keep it on one definition instead of changing it every day. But that's all I had on that one. No, but also I want to add that Libras will make you seem like you crazy and they will play victim and make you seem like you really is crazy. That's why I like that she got into it with the Aries. Because the Aries don't care. They stand on what they said and they said what they said and you ain't gonna twist their mind around. They know what they said and they know what they meant. And it is what it is. But a Libra, you got to watch them because they're very manipulative when it comes to arguments and they know how to win an argument. They know. Just like how she did the Ice Spice, how she baited Ice Spice. Ice Spice took the bait. Ooh, one thing about Cardi B, that girl can argue. That girl can argue when she wants to. One thing about it. But yeah, that's all I had on Ramonte and Cardi B. Please comment your thoughts. Is Ramonte an influencer? Should Cardi B handled that differently? And what do you think would be the best approach for ghetto influencers or ghetto celebrities? Should they change who they are to get the brand deals? Or should the brand deals learn how to market them better? Let me know below. And make sure you subscribe and you like the video.
Not on my level. To deceased is central and free from a land to Japan with this romance. If you can't dance, if you can't sing, put your hands in the air about your dancing. See it to the people.